when I went to identify his body, there's no other way to say it, but I wanted to kill them. I was going to kill them.
There are a few child abuse cases New Zealand can't forget. In 2015, 3-year-old Moko Rangitoheriri was killed by his caregivers, while his mum was at Starship Hospital looking after his sick brother, and his dad, Jordon, was on home detention after just getting out of prison.
Tania Schaeler and David Haerewa each sentenced to 17 years behind bars. 9 years non-parole for the manslaughter of 3-year-old Moko Rangitoheriri.
Moko, he was beautiful, cheeky and mischief in the joy of the room. I remember the day before I got out, I rung their mum and I got to talk to them. And I said to my daughter, love you, my baby. And she said, love you, dad. And I said to Moko, love you, son. And he said, yep. And I said, love you, son. And he said, yep. I said, don't you love dad? And he said, no, bye, dad. And then he left, and that was the last words that he ever spoke to me and I ever spoke to him. He just wanted to go play and, yeah. Yard 117, Waikerea Prison, the day before I got out. And then I got out, went on home detention. The next time I seen him was Starship. And I had to identify his body.
Growing up, Jordon didn't have a dad.
Well, I think if I had a father to teach me how to be a father, then I could have been a better father for him. I could have been a better father for all my kids. It breaks me every day. Growing up, I remember not having enough food all the time. You know, single mum on the benefit with 5 kids. I think that was pretty hard for her, and that's what pushed me towards the gangs, I suppose. I just wanted more for us, wanted better things for us, so I figured out I can go to people's houses and jump the fence and steal new white socks off their lines and shoes off their doorsteps.
Violence was always part of his life.
I always wanted power, so I used violence to take it. So this means mangu kaha, it's black power in Māori. So I created this and put it on my face because I wanted everyone to know who I was and to intimidate them pretty much. It wasn't until I really lost my son that I sort of realised that I needed to change, and I wanted to change, but I didn't know how to change. And
Jordon was haunted by thoughts of killing the people who killed his son.
I used to have nightmares all night of chasing these people and trying to kill them and shooting them, and they just wouldn't die. Yeah.
Eventually, his new partner encouraged him to go to a men's anti-violence workshop. It was run by She's Not Your Rehab, an organisation started by Matt and Sarah Brown that helps men take responsibility for their healing.
So She Is Not Your Rehab pretty much helped save that, I think. If I didn't meet Matt and Sarah, then I could be still thinking those thoughts.
It was a workshop with other men that changed him.
They got us to partner up, and we had to look each other in the eyes. They said that you had to connect hearts, so I walked up to the male that was in front of me, and I just had overwhelming anxiety. The first thought that came to my head was smash him in the face before he smashes you in the face. And I feel like that's just how we were raised. And then I had to get rid of that thought, breathe, look him in his eye, let all that awkwardness and emotions go, and then give him the nod, and then the cheer broke, and then give him a hug, which was the most out of it feeling I've ever felt in my life. Like, it was crazy. And then I had to do it another 10 or 20 times with other men, and they were screaming out all those hugs your father's never gave you, hug your partner harder. And I looked around, and there was massive, fully grown men, you know, of all walks, gangs, crying. And it made me cry. And my partner was on my shoulder, and he was crying too. That was awkward. but it was also life-changing. It was the first time that I sat in a room full of men and we cried and we were trying to make it normal. Well, for me, anxiety, panic attacks, awkwardness, being uncomfortable, the only way I could deal with it was violence. I don't use violence anymore. Don't get me wrong, I get frustrated sometimes, you know, and pissed off, but I've got tools in my toolbox now that I can use, and it's okay to talk, it's okay to cry, it's okay to open up, be vulnerable, be proud to know that you can cry, and accept the hugs. That was one of the hardest for me. Tell your bros that you love them. Tell other men that you love them.